Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, WIT Solapur. Now today I am going to explain you voltage to current converters part 2. Learning outcomes of this session are: at the end of the session, students will be able to draw and derive expressions for output current of V to I converters, and second is design of V to I converters. Contents of the session are V to I converters with offset, second is derivation of load current, and design of V to I converters. So first, V to I converter with offset. This is the circuit for V to I converter with a offset. Plus VCC minus VEE operational amplifier. From inverting terminal, a resistance R span, adjustable resistance, is connected to the ground. This is a load. So load current I naught is controlled by V in and V reference. So this is input, this is V reference, these are the resistances of 1 meg. Now this is the transfer curve for this V to I converter with offset. From the transfer curve, we see that if input voltage is VA, the load current is IA, and similarly when input voltage is VB, load current is IB. Now from this transfer curve, we see that when the input voltage is 0, the load current is not 0. Means when input voltage is 0, this is the load current. So this is the offset, and due to this offset, we say this is V to I converter with offset, and offset depends on V reference. Now this is circuit. Now we proceed further for the derivation of the load current I naught. For the given circuit, voltage at non-inverting terminal Vx can be obtained by application of superposition theorem. So by superposition theorem, voltage at point X, Vx, is equal to input voltage V in into 1 meg upon 1 meg plus 1 meg, that is V in by 2, plus V reference into 1 meg upon 1 meg plus 1 meg, that is V reference by 2. So this is equal to V in plus V reference divided by 2. Considering ideal op-amp, voltage at inverting and non-inverting terminal should be equal, that is V plus equal to V minus. Now V minus is equal to V2 as shown in figure, which is equal to Vx, and Vx is obtained as V in plus V reference by 2. Now voltage across R span, that is V2, is given by load current I naught multiplied by the resistance R span. So V2 is equal to IO into R span, that is equal to Vx, V in plus V reference by 2. Simplifying further, we get I naught equal to V in plus V reference upon 2 into R span. Let this is equation number 1. Now simplifying further, we get R span is equal to V in plus V reference upon 2 I naught. Now from the transfer curve, we are having the two points, point A and point B. At point A, input voltage is VA and input current, output current is IA. Similarly, at point B, input voltage is VB and the load current is IB. So substituting these values in the R span, we get equation A and B as shown in figure. Simplifying further, we get 2 into R span into IA equal to VA plus V reference. Let this is equation number C, and 2 into R span into IB equal to VB plus V reference. Let this is equation number D. Now subtracting equations C from D, we get VB minus VA is equal to 2 R span in the bracket IB minus IA. Simplifying further, we get R span equal to VB minus VA upon 2 in the bracket IB minus IA. Let this is equation number 2. Then from equation number B, we can obtain the value of V reference. So solving equation number B, we get V reference equal to 2 into R span into IB minus VB. Now let this is equation number 3. Now recall which type of V2I converters you have learned up till now and what are their circuits and design equations. So we have learned 4 different V2I converters. So first V2I converter is V2I converter with floating load, and the design equation for this converter is I0 is equal to Vin divided by R1, and RL is the load. Second V2I converter is V2I converter with grounded load as shown in figure, and the design equation for this V2I converter is I0 is equal to Vin divided by R. So here R1 is equal to RF is equal to R, and this is a load. So all resistances, this is R, R, this is R, this is R, and this is a load. And I0 is given by Vin by R. Now third type of V2I converter is V2I converter with offset. So this is the circuit, R span, this is load, Vin, V reference, plus VCC and minus VE. And for this circuit, these are the design equations, R span, and this is V reference. So R span is given by VB minus VE upon 2 in the bracket IB minus IA, and V reference 2 R span into IB minus VB. And the fourth V2I converter is differential V2I converter. So this is E1, E2, and these are the resistances, this is load. And IL is given by E2 minus E1 upon RS. Now design of V2I converter basically consists of the two steps. First is selection of V2I converter from specifications of design problem. And second is whatever V2I converter is selected in step number 1, that is design in detail. That is circuit and the design of components in the circuit. Now let us take the design problem. Design V2I converter for the input voltage minus 5 volt to 10 volt, and the required output current is 4 milliampere to 20 milliampere. From the given data, transfer curve can be plotted as, this is transfer curve, means if input is VA is minus 5 volt, at that time IA is 4 milliampere and input is 10 volt. Load current is 20 milliampere as shown in figure. So this is given input and this is output current. Now first is selection of circuit. So we have selected V2I converter with offset, because when input is 0, load current is not 0. Now R span is calculated by using this formula VB minus VA divided by 2 in the bracket IB minus IA. Substituting the values VB 10 volt, VA minus 5, 2 in the bracket IB minus IA. Simplifying further, we get R span is equal to 468.7 ohm. Now 1 kilo ohm potentiometer is used as a R span, which is adjusted to the value 468.7 ohm. And the V reference is calculated as V reference is equal to 2 into R span into IB minus VB. Therefore, V reference is equal to, substituting the value of R span and IB, we get V reference equal to 8.75 volt. Now this is the circuit. Now in this circuit, operational amplifier 1 meg, 1 meg, V in, V reference, R span, and this is load. Now R-span is selected as a 1K pot as said earlier, and V reference is 8.75 volt. Now next is selection of the operational amplifier. So 741 is selected as a op amp. Now select VCC is equal to plus 12, minus VE is equal to minus 12 volt. Now V reference of 8.75 volt is obtained as below from the potentiometer. 1K potentiometer is used, one end is connected to the ground and one end is connected to the plus 12 volt. And by adjusting this pot, a V reference of 8.75 volt is adjusted as shown in figure. These are references. Thank you for watching this video.